Meet Eva Simone Franki. She was born and raised in Budapest, Hungary. That's Eva, bottom left. She came to the U.S. in 1956, first saw Sergio in 64 at the famed Coconut Grove. He walked on stage and her heart stood still.
Good evening. Welcome to the Coconut Grove. I love this place, I love this room, I love this town.
Eva's life changed in 77 when she finally met the handsome young tenor from Italy who exploded on the American entertainment scene in the early 60s. Sergio and Eva married in 81. They had a fabulous marriage while living on a scenic 240-acre property in Stonington, Connecticut. Always the proud wife, Eva was eager to display the many photos highlighting Sergio's illustrious career.
Eva!
Hi. You were responsible for this. Hi, hi.
I'm the guilty one.
The guilty one. No, I never wanted this, but Eva thought that I should have them.
You never wanted it? I mean,
no.
This is a lovely wall.
Maybe because I lived through all of this, you know. And
he felt like it would be kind of showing off putting his pictures out. So one by one, I sneaked them out. I had them framed. One particular day, he was away performing without me. I didn't go with him. So I picked it all up and I hanged them all up.
I mean, so you physically took a
hand. Oh, yes.
Physically, because if he hears me hammering away, he would stop me instantly.
And so since then, I've been complaining, saying, why is this here instead of being there? And this one.
Of the many extraordinary experiences Eva and Sergio shared through the years, none was more memorable than a performance at the White House for the Reagans. It began with a phone call.
Sergio was doing the Broadway show 9 that time, and Frank Sinatra called backstage, hey, Cic. Cic means Frank in Italian. So they said, Mr. Frank Sinatra is on the line. So Sergio picked up and said, hey, Cic, what's up? He said, Sergio, I need you. I need you, the president of Spain is coming, and we need your singing.
Sergio was performing on Broadway, but he was able to break away. So he and Eva were off to Washington.
So they said, Sergio, can you bring it down the voice? Sergio said, well, okay, why don't you hire Perry Como, for Christ's sake? Anyway, or Julio Iglesias, why me? I said, well, he had that big voice, therefore he has to let it out to be Sergio Franki. Anyway, so what happened is Nancy Reagan came down and said, okay, we're gonna move the concert to the Rose Garden.
Good idea.
Outside. So Nancy Reagan come down and was hurrying, getting all the shawls she can get together, shawls and rope, something to put on in case some ladies with the evening gowns needed a wrap.
Yeah.
Tragedy struck in 1990 when Sergio lost his battle to cancer at just 62. His last performance was at the Warwick Musical Theater. Not to get swallowed up in the sorrow, the energetic Eva went on a mission to keep her husband's music and memory alive. 4 years later, the Sergio Franki Memorial Concert was born in her own backyard, featuring multi-talented and well-known tenors accompanied by a 32-piece symphony orchestra.
To welcome David Miller. This is the husband who sang together with his beautiful wife. And I don't know, he's a wonderful tenor. And I don't know how many of you know, he's the lead singer from Il Divo.
Well,
David Miller.
I don't know about the lead singer, I'm a singer. But
if you are here, you're the lead.
This concert started off many, many years ago, as you know. And it was a dream to keep Sergio's memory alive through the music.
And she has chosen to make the Sergio Franki concert her life.
Oh!
most important part of the concert is that it gives back. It's dedicated to serving young people, to providing scholarship support, and really bringing young people with an interest in the arts the opportunity to pursue that.
To give a chance to a young one to grow. And that's what the foundation is about. And I always put my foot down. I said, the music got to have a flow. Sing a love song, sing opera. And I'm so honored that you come. Really, it's heaven.
It's a foundation that has handed out $1.3 million in scholarship awards to more than 600 aspiring young talented singers. Eva is involved in every facet of the concert. She is promoter, producer, and a most entertaining hostess.
Okay. Yeah. And you're doing well. I can see you wearing a Prada shoe.
It's Dior.
Dior, excuse me.
She awards $80,000 a year in scholarships, and those very recipients come back the next year and put the concert on. And so it's an evolving, and it's a wonderful thing to see.
The concert is a happening. Thousands from around the Northeast bring their baskets and chairs to the Franke Estate in Stonington every August. Eva picks every performer.
Eva Franke is the absolutely the passion behind this and the personality behind it, and people get involved because of Eva.
Love you, Eva. Isn't it wonderful to break it up? Love songs and opera, it's heavenly.
Well, Eva is such a force of nature. She really is. She is such a dynamo, and you know, this event is her baby.
With the same drive and determination as when she started, today Eva and her helpers are preparing for a 23rd concert 11 weeks from tonight.
I tried to find someone that would be something like Sergio. I got the kid. He's 25 years old. He's magnificent.
Sergio were with us today. What do you think he would say about that?
I'm out of my mind. He would say, Eva, stop it. Probably he would, but I think he would be very touched.
And he would also be impressed by Eva's generosity and all she has done for so many worthy organizations.
I don't think there's a nonprofit agency in the town here that she doesn't help out in some way, because she donates her property, her tickets, or she'll donate a night out here at which she'll cook for people to come in here, and they raffle that off, and the nonprofits benefit from that.
No wonder she has received awards from so many organizations. Tonight, one more: the Da Vinci Center's prestigious Community Humanitarian Award. How appropriate.
Like the Da Vinci Center, where you're looking at some of these youths that would probably never have the opportunity if it wasn't for the center. That's what Eva gives to these young singers. And so they were able to aspire for their dreams.
There's no one better than Eva Franke to receive this award. Just her commitment, not just to remembering Sergio, but in terms of wanting to help young musicians be successful.
We brought something to Stonington, to our area, not only Stonington, to New London, to Mystic, to Westerly, Rhode Island. I love our area. I'm honored to be here, and forever, let's have that music play.
That you must go, fate that let us meet, was indiscreet to let me fall.